Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a, well, it's half wearable and half special effects look for you. My inspiration for this look I'll share later in this video. It was really, really, really random. But anyways, yeah, so this is more of a sexy cat eye type of look. And then the actual cat is on this side. So yeah, it's a lot of fun to do. If you want to do this as a normal beauty look, by the way, you could totally just do this eye look on both eyes. Or if you want to go full on leopard print, you could do this over your entire face. It's up to you. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so we're starting off with foundation already done. You can just apply that as usual. Then for the concealer, however, we are going to do things differently. I'm only going to apply it on this side of my face because obviously this side is going to be the cat's eye thing, so it's not excessively useful to put on like heaps of concealer first and then cover it all with face paint, so we're not going to bother doing that. However, I do want to go for a very, you know, full face, full on sexy, hot looking face. This sounds weird, but like I want to go full on with the human side of my face. So I'm going to use a very pale concealer. So as you can tell, I applied it like basically almost in the drag like areas on this side of my face, obviously, because here is going to be the leopard spot. Just keep in mind where you want to put that so you don't bother applying this. I should really start blending this out because the stuff dries really quickly. But I'm just blending it out with my foundation brush because that just, you know, it also contains the foundation, or at least little remnants of it, so it's just going to help it blend. And I'm also going to do contour on this side of my face and my nose. And then just going to quickly powder. Okay, at this point, well, here is the proof that contouring actually is visible. Yeah, you're gonna look a bit lopsided and odd at this point, but we're just gonna ignore that. Now for the eyebrows, actually we're gonna make it worse, because now it's time for the eyebrows. No, it's time for the eyebrow, because we're only gonna fill in one on the human side of the face. Now I'm gonna go for the more extreme drawn on brows, rather than my as usual more natural brows, like more the Insta-perfect brows, you know, of the olden days. I actually don't really do brows like this on Instagram either, to be honest. Actually, on Instagram I just post the same looks as I put on my YouTube channel. But anyways, but yeah, I don't know, like, sometimes you just feel like it. Instabrow is done. So now it's time for the eye look. Eye look, only one eye, yes. I'm going to use the Catrice Cosmetics Neon Earth Palette. If you don't have this, obviously just use whatever products you do have. And I'm just going to use my very simple method of putting a brush against my eye, or the back of it, putting on color, and then you'll have a winged look. Super easy. And of course, you're not immediately done at this point. You do gotta blend for like 12 hours. And after that, still, I'm probably going to put some gold right here. Okay, fun fact, this color is actually called gold in this palette. Everything, like specifically the color I use, will be listed below the video as always. But anyway. Then I'm going to go into an almost white shade, put it on my brow bone, wipe off the brush, and just make sure this is absolutely as smooth as I can get it. And below the eye I'm putting a red shade, which admittedly is a bit more pigmented than I thought it was for some reason. But yeah, I'm just blending it mostly in my outer corner and carefully blending it inwards. Then the inner corner is going to get a white gold shimmer. Okay, and at that point we're done with basically the eyeshadow, as I often do on my channel. By the way, if you don't want to miss any makeup tutorials, including ones, you know, mostly ones actually where we do vault eyes the same way and it actually turns out wearable, then please subscribe to my channel, and if you want to, you can also like the video, please do, because it just really helps me to get my video out there and, you know, help more people to see it. But yeah, for the eye look, we're now going to move to eyeliner, and I'm going to do the cat's eyeliner with like a little point in the front, and then obviously just the wing on the outside. Okay, so the eye is done. If you want this to be a wearable look, then just copy this to this eye, as well as the concealer and everything. Anyway, but yeah, what I'm gonna do is just apply blush on this side of my face now, and then we can finally move on to the leopard side. The color I'm using is a peachy shade, because it fits with the eye look. And then also applying a gold shaded highlighter. Now the key is to just not be too difficult about this, just make a line around your face, ending it in sort of a pointy way, because I want it to look like my skin folded around it. We're still gonna have to do that effect, obviously. But yeah, just don't overthink it, just start somewhere, that's the easiest. I'm starting off with yellow, and then I'm going to apply orange on it. I'm going to blend the orange over top of it, really, because I want the eventual results to match the eye look in color. So yeah, that's gonna be a challenge. Okay, I just decided to put the orange in the outer corners and sort of blend it inward so it becomes a bit of shading as well. Also, by the way, in case you're wondering how I got the inspiration for this look, Heel Holland Bakt, which is the Dutch version of Great British Bake Off, but obviously Dutch and not British. Seriously, it's the most random thing really, but the episode that was, like the episode before, on the Sunday before I filmed this, there was this like theme of an inside out cake. So basically the outside of the cake had to look like something, and then the theme had to be continued on the inside. So for example, someone made like a honey and bee themed cake on the outside, and then the inside looked like a bee's body, you know, with like the yellow and brown stripes. Which was really fun, and like one of the judges was wearing a leopard print dress, and then the man who presents it, the show, was making a joke about it, and that just gave me the idea to do a inside out makeup really in the theme of those cakes. So sort of go with the, you know, beauty but sort of leopard themed beauty look, and then on the inside you have the actual leopard print. But instead of a cake, obviously in makeup, because I don't want to cut my own face open. So yeah, like that's how I get inspiration as a makeup artist. The most random of things. Okay, now I just made a decision that I might actually regret. But I want to do the same eyeliner as I did on this eye as well. But then in brown, so I'm just going to use a brown liner and pencil for that and hope for the best. Okay, seriously, when I was doing the other side, I seriously was happy that I wouldn't have to do it on the other eye. Sometimes I wonder if I secretly don't like myself when I make decisions like these. Okay, this is not my best eyeliner ever, but in my defense, I used the brown one less than the black one. And the brown one is already like basically empty, somehow. But yeah, those are the frustrations of life. Now, on to shading. And what I'm basically doing is I'm just using a small smudging brush and my black body paint dry. I'm doing this beforehand because I know myself, and if I do the leopard spots first and make this paint wet, then I'm just going to end up grabbing the wet paint and accidentally give myself zebra stripes when I do the shading. I don't want to risk that, so I'm doing this while my paint is still, the black paint at least, is still dry. Because I'm just using it as a blending thing. I just want to do shading with this, like I said. Because I want this to be, like, I don't want to outline this. I want this to be realistic. Realistic. So yeah, and this way I can just really make a nice deep shadow. With a nice crisp line without risk of fallout, which would be a thing if I were to use eyeshadow for this. Okay, shading done, and as you can tell, hopefully tell, it makes a lot of difference immediately. But yeah, anyways, do keep in mind, with the whole realism thing and all, if light comes from the top, then the shadows on the top are going to be deeper and darker and bigger than the ones on the bottom, because the light is hitting it more. If you get what I mean. So, keep that in mind. Anyway, then it's time to go grab a brown body paint and a black body paint and some form of example of leopard spots and paint them on. Okay, remember how I said that we weren't going to do an outline? I completely accidentally lied because I'm looking at it and I do want an outline, so I'm going to make an outline with a very thin liner brush and the black paint. Then back to the smudging brush and a dry part, be careful, but dry part of the black body paint. And blend it inwards because I do want the outside to have an outline. I want that line to be crisp. But I don't want it to be crisp on the inside. For some reason that would sound very strange out of context. Anyway, I don't want to be a crispy leopard. Just blend it out on the inside, the shading, okay? That's all I'm trying to say here. Okay, so the shading is shading again, and also I have an accidental cut crease line. That's not on purpose, that's because my body paint was sticky and then the eyeliner sort of smushed onto it. But I'm not mad at it. If your body paint and eyeliner combination doesn't automatically do this, then you don't have to, of course. But actually, I think I'm just gonna play it up a little bit more, because I kinda like it. Sometimes a makeup just does itself, it's so nice. Like Bob Ross said, we don't make mistakes, we just have happy accidents. Yeah, anyway, happy accident aside, I'm just going to do a sort of highlight now around my skin opening with a nude pencil. That sounded so strange. Actually, before I do that, I'm just going to lengthen the lines a little bit and make it look a little bit more with like wrinkles and all with the smudging brush. Like my skin is actually falling open there. You could make this entirely gory and like 3D-esque. I'm not going to because I don't feel like doing that. I want to keep it more to like the beauty side of things, I suppose. But that's up to you. Okay, so far so good. I'm quite pleased. You could blend it out a little bit with your fingers if you want, and that's it. Now I'm just going to go do my lips in a nude shade and we're done. claims us with the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, again, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you don't want to miss any future videos of mine, then please subscribe. I actually personally really like how this turned out. It turned out way better than I expected, especially the color is really nice and vibrant. I don't know, I really like it. I don't really know where you could actually wear something like this, but I feel tempted to just go grocery shopping like this, because it's never the normal beauty looks, it's always the looks like these, of which I'm like, I never want to take this off and I want to look like this forever. Which is highly inconvenient, really. But yeah, anyways. Oh, and also, if you have any suggestions of other types of animals you would like to see me do a look of with, like, the whole half face sort of thingy, then please tell me in the comment section below, because I really want to do more looks like these, but I always somehow end up with animals with, like, the same color scheme, and then the eye look would look the same every time. I could do something with, like, a giraffe and then, like, very long lashes. Idea. But anyway, if you have suggestions, please tell me. Other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!